Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I will be showing you how to make an LED strip thing at home. The first thing you'll want to do is find a power supply. Now I do not recommend doing this if you are not experienced in electricity, but as you can see, that's the polarity. So the line that's going inside is this, so it says the inside is positive, the outer is negative. You have to pay attention to that, or you can short, or you will short this out, or these out if you put it in the wrong way. So that's polarity. So make sure you get a proper power supply, but you can also do this. Now remember, only do this if you know what you're doing. If you don't know what you're doing, that professional will do it. I'm definitely not a professional either. So as you can see, this is mainly how it would be. And as you can see, it would be connected to the LED strips. And yes, I did find an SD card for my camera. The next thing you'll want to do is make sure that you find a GFCI outlet, and then make sure that you have the right polarity. Just in case something does go wrong, you'll want to use this. The way that you know that is by these. So make sure that you test it before you do this. Just make sure it doesn't do any harm. So as you can see, this is here. Will it work? Okay, so it just wasn't startled me. So these are the LED strips. So it's not fully in. So as you can see, it wasn't, well, you can't really see, but it wasn't touching the side, because as you can see, so you probably won't be able to see that, there was a little bit of light left from this. So what you'll want to do is take this out, I guess, maybe like spread this apart. Be right back. Okay, I have a knife here. You will. Okay, I was not able to cut that, so I'm just going to fold it inward. Okay, I bent the cable. Let's test it now. Still isn't working. You may have seen that it flickered, so wait for it to discharge slowly. Okay, so now I have, it's not turning the cable. Okay, things may work. And no, it's not now. Great. And I'll fix this, I'll be right back. Now I am back. The issue was, it's, the tape wasn't tight enough for to make proper contact, so it was not working until I made it work. So it to be okay, should work now. And look at this, it works. Okay, so now for VF setting, I have this stuff here. I can open this. Oh, I ruined the bag. I was going to feed this bag to hold stuff in. So as you can see, this is tubing thingy. So what you'll want to do, you'll need to cut it to size. I got scissors. So now you'll need to measure this. Now this is just optional. You don't need to add this cool stuff. So right here. Then I can see how to cut this. So. Not see, whatever. Now, if you have this type, you can just kind of undo it and put it around the cables. Excuse me. And then just tie it like this. Okay, now we have this tubing over it. Looks quite nicer. So I have this duct tape right here. I will put this right here, as you can see. Now, you can add a connector. I recommend doing that, but I do not have one handy, so this will just have to do. This looks fine in my opinion. It's going to be behind my desk, so I'm not too worried about the aesthetic of it. Actually, probably not behind my desk. I don't know. It's long enough. I will measure it after this. Okay, guys, this looks much better. Now, as you can see, there are places to cut that. I'm not going to be cutting this, most likely. And now, what I'm going to do with the rest of this, I don't think you asked, but you can make really cool things out of these in general. I recommend keeping it. Don't throw it away, just have it somewhere. Now we have the desk here. So, as you can see, you can plug this in and nothing bad should happen. Okay. It's actually quite cool how it fades out. So, now I have this Ergotron desk. Let me try and put it behind there. See how it looks. Guys, this looks awesome. I think it's going to be betterly placed or whatever. That looks sick. I think I'm going to have it like this. Anyway, that is how you can set up an LED strip easy without spending a lot of money on a power supply for it and stuff. I totally recommend this. Just one suggestion, please be careful about this. Do this at your own risk, because if you use a power supply like I did, it has to meet all the requirements of LEDs. Now, you can look up power supply for these and compare it and see if it works. Now, if you know what you're doing and you know this will work, go for it. I think it's an awesome idea. Anyway, see you guys later. This is my new transition to out. Actually, slower. Bye.